Hello and welcome to Meet the Boss TV. In this program, how to ensure there's mileage in your cloud journey with Toyota's Ron Guerrier. People often refer to cloud-based projects as a journey and not something that can be achieved in a single leap forward. It's more of a phased transformation that requires the IT organization to review and revise operations in many different areas. Everything from strategy to technology, people to processes. But every journey has to begin somewhere. And for Ron Guerrier, CIO of Toyota Financial Services, it comes down to where your organization is on the maturity curve.
The challenge that most companies have is depends on the maturation or how mature the organization is. If the organization's net new, like a .com coming right out of the gate, going straight to cloud makes tremendous sense. You reduce infrastructure, headcount, resources. There's a lot of pluses jumping right into a cloud solution. A very quick journey. However, if you're a more mature organization, you have a lot of legacy applications, a lot of legacy systems, that journey is a lot more treacherous. You have to make certain decisions. Things that you used to do as CapEx changes to OpEx, so your structure changes. The resources you need changes as well. There's a lot more dependency on network individuals to connect with SaaS providers, PaaS providers, and IaaS providers. So it's a whole different way of thinking when you go to the cloud, and you just have to be prepared for what that looks like.
And where would you say that Toyota is on that journey?
We have a lot of legacy systems. We have systems that are 29 years old, 28 years off release. And to just jump to the cloud doesn't quite make sense for us. So what we're doing is we're looking at certain applications that do make sense to go to a cloud solution, and we're readdressing our legacy applications and making the changes needed to prepare them for that. The other challenge we have, quite honestly, especially here in the States, is regulations. We are heavily regulated due to the fact we are a financial services organization that sells insurance products. So we have to make sure that if we do go to a cloud solution, we still have the rigor and discipline needed to meet the stringent requirements of state and federal laws.
So how do you go about choosing which applications you're going to move to the cloud, which parts of your data you move to the cloud? You know, how do you make that choice?
Once you get that first application, that first leg in a cloud solution, then you start looking at the other parts of the organization. What we're doing is we're looking at our apps that are on the fringes, not our core legacy systems, which, like I mentioned before, is a challenge. We're looking at the other systems where we could potentially go to a cloud solution. One of the biggest challenges we face when moving those is essentially documenting the current state. Because when you do want to go to the new state, it's best to understand kind of your current environment. And when you have an organization that's roughly 28, 29 years old, people forget exactly why we did what in the system. People retire, people move on, and your ability to document your current state is extremely important, so you know exactly where you want to go. Now, some things, obviously, you just want to do away with and start fresh, but you have to understand the logic as to why things are the way they are today.
So what opportunities do you think that this movement towards the cloud is offering, both for you as a CIO and for the organization as a whole?
As a CIO, one of the things that is critical for my role is I have to stay in touch with, obviously, technology, but also the needs of the business. It's not the old days where you build it and they will come. That practice has gone away. The other thing in my role and what cloud provides me is it provides enhanced capabilities to the business. Again, I could stay on release and hopefully I could do it cheaper. The one thing I also need to do, though, is explain to my business peers that the cloud is not simple. A lot of folks in the business, they read a magazine and say, hey, we can just move it to the cloud. And it seems relatively simple, conceptually. But when you actually have to put it in practice, it is, as you spoke of earlier, it's a journey. You have to make sure you have the documentation in place. You have the right talents retained. You don't outsource or put in the cloud your DNA. There's certain things that you need to hold true as a technologist. So cloud is an answer, but it's not the complete answer. My role is to say, what is best for my organization? Is this offering better for me, or is this offering better for me? And build that rapport with those organizations to make sure that we're top of mind. Because when you do go into the cloud world, you become one of many. And if there is an outage, you want to make sure that you are top of mind for that cloud offering to make sure that they are bringing you up and all that. So it's the relationships you build with these cloud companies is critical. It's absolutely critical.
In many ways, the IT environment itself is a heterogeneous, multi-vendor type environment. And more companies are taking that approach to the way that they manage the cloud these days, making sure that the solutions that they choose are able to handle that heterogeneity.
You really have to do a lot of supplier and vendor management to make sure that the value stream is essentially aligned. So there's a lot more brokering, quite honestly, that the CIOs, people in IT, have to do, as opposed to hands-on programming. It's a whole different mindset that you have to have, and it's working, but it's a journey, as you mentioned. And the biggest change, as I mentioned earlier, is that when you do go to the cloud, those capital investments of a data center go away. It's essentially more OpEx. And if you're spending more OpEx, it changes your balance sheet. It's changing exactly where you're spending the money. So the conversation with your executives on the business side also differs. It's not the Taj Mahal data centers. It is now this theoretical thing up there, and just trust me, it's going to be working at all times. So you put a lot more trust into your cloud offering providers as well, because as a CIO, it's a matter of phone call as opposed to go physically seeing what's there.
For Guerrier, this has meant a fundamental change in the relationship the IT department has with the rest of the organisation, from functional utility to a true business enabler where dialogue with stakeholders and the executive team is key.
We used to be essentially a command and control. You give us a ticket, we fix the ticket. More low utility. And what we started doing is we restructured. So we have our chief technology officer, and Geraldine Ramazzani. She's in charge of the infrastructure, the architecture, and the engineering. But we've created the role of division information officer. So essentially, these individuals face off to a respective business executive. And essentially, they're an extension of their staff. So when the head of sales, for example, has an idea, he'll throw out iPads to 300 salespeople in the field. He partners with his division information officer. They work on a solution. They come back, back to our IT shop, and we work on a solution. But we're trying to cater our offerings and our services unique to each line of business. So we have sales, servicing with our call centers, and we have corporate services, which includes a treasury floor where we trade commercial paper every morning, and we also have a risk department. So each one of those groups has a respective IT person who's just focused on their needs. And it changed the conversation we had at the business.
Moving to the cloud is a change. People generally fear change. But it's particularly at the corporate level, I guess, and change requires education. So to what extent is kind of education around the cloud important as to what is possible, what's not possible, the risks and the potential rewards as well?
I'm pretty proud to say that whether we have people with long tenures here at Toyota Financial Services or people we just hired out of college or just started 3 months ago, everyone understands that our role has changed. And we need to be kind of part of the thought leadership in that change. So we have town hall sessions. Our chief technology officer has brown bag sessions. We bring in cloud providers to kind of have conversations with all rank and file. We do a lot of things to make sure that we're staying in front of kind of where the trend is going. But you're right, change, it scares people. And as a leadership team, we have to make sure that we prepare them, let them know that change is good. And the best part of change is when you're actually in front of it, the best you can, and help drive that change. And so far, it's come along. People are getting it, they're understanding it, and they're like, okay, how do we do this? How do we do that? And quite honestly, they're raising their hand. How can I get more training on what this new world looks like? Which is pretty exciting. It does give a lot more capabilities to the business. It does make it exciting. It does enable the business, but you have to understand what that agility and flexibility provides. You have to be disciplined enough to understand what you're walking into. If done right, it can be brilliant, but you better have a strategy walking into that. Going in, turning switches, and all that good stuff, it could actually hurt you in the long run if you don't do it right. Education is extremely important. You have to go in with your eyes wide open. If you don't, it could really come back and bite you.
For more fantastic interviews directly related to your business, be sure to explore Meet the Boss TV.